Hello friends. So today we will learn about language and some minute structure of language. As said by Benjamin Lee, language shapes the way we think and determines what we think we can think about. Now if we look at the language, there are minutest structure of language which makes the language complete. And if we would not know these structures, it would become very difficult for us to communicate to any language, lest it be English language. So today we will learn about various minute structures in English language, which we also called as parts of speech. Some of it that I would like to enumerate for you. These are pronouns, articles, conjunctions, prepositions, and interjections. So, here we go now. Thank you. Since languages are incomplete without sentences, we will majorly use statements for our examples and references. So, let us look at these examples. First one, Mahatma Gandhi was a freedom fighter. He played a significant role in freedom struggle. Next, Malala is a brave girl. She fought back in adversities. Now notice the highlighted words in the first statement. He is being referred for Mahatma Gandhi. Likewise, in the second statement, she is being referred for Malala. Both Malala and Mahatma Gandhi are proper nouns, but he and she are not nouns. And such kind of words which are referring to the nouns are called as pronouns. So let us look at what are pronouns. Pronouns are the words used instead of a noun. We often use them to avoid repeating the noun that they refer to. For example, Malala is a brave girl. Malala fought back in adversities. Looks very weird and funny. And therefore, we use the word she or the pronoun she over there. Also, pronouns have different forms for different ways we use them, which we will see in the coming slides. The nouns that the pronoun stands for are also called as antecedents. So these nouns are the antecedents when we are referring in the context of pronoun. Now, look at these. These are the various forms of pronouns that we will learn today. Look at the statement. So this first one, Monica is a brilliant girl. She is the favorite of all the teachers. All of them admire her. Now look at the person the pronoun is standing for, or the thing for which that pronoun stands. They are highlighted. She is the favorite of all. All of them admired her. So she, them, and her. These kinds of words would be called as personal pronouns. Now, in the personal pronouns, we can have the subtypes. First one, what we can have is the subject pronouns, which are used as the subject of a verb. For example, these three statements we look at. I like your dress. Now, what is the verb over here? Like. And who likes it? I like it. Therefore, I is the subject of the verb and I is a personal pronoun. You are late. Now, where are is not a direct verb, but it is an auxiliary. Still, since it is a helping verb, you becomes the subject pronoun. He is my friend. Same way, is an auxiliary and therefore he is the subject personal pronoun. Next is the object pronoun, which is used as the object of a verb. So here we look at the three statements. Can you help me, please? Now here if you see, you is the subject pronoun and me becomes the object pronoun because it comes after the verb help. Okay. Second, I can see you. Now the verb over here is see. And therefore, the pronoun next to see would be the object pronoun. Last one you can see. We saw them. So them is a object pronoun. In town yesterday, but they didn't see us. Again, us becomes the object pronoun. Therefore, we can say that the subject pronoun and the object pronoun are synced. They are synced together. If there is a subject pronoun and an object pronoun has to be used, then it would be like this. The subject pronoun is I, object pronoun would be me. For you, that is the second person, we do not change the subject and the object pronoun, it remains same. Then for third person, he, it becomes him, she, her. Again, it is a neutral gender and therefore it remains the same. We, us, you, you, they, them. So these are personal pronouns. Now, there are some important points that we should remember, which we also call as exceptions in English language. So what are these exceptions? Let us take a look at them. Hello, it's George. Now we have used a pronoun over here for George, it's. It's me, it's male. Look, it's Donald Trump. Who is that? I think it's John's brother. Now it over here is very significant and it is used in variety of ways that we talk about, whether it is about ourselves or whether it is about somebody else. So if we are not visible to someone else or when someone else is not visible to us, then we can say that we need to use it. For example, hello, it's George. So suppose I am talking on phone and I need to refer to myself. So the word it comes in over here, the personal pronoun it comes in. Similarly, you are referring to somebody who has not seen you, but you are seeing that person. So it's Donald Trump, it's John's brother. Sometimes when we see a new person also, we can use the word it. For all the non-living things, objects, situations, events, etc., we can use the word it. Next word is there. There's an interesting book on the shelf. There was a nasty fight. There were 20 people at the meeting. Now, in what cases do we use there? There is used when there is no other subject, or where or when something is, a number, amount, or something existing or happening. So we can use it and there both over here. There's an interesting book. This is used for the book which is there somewhere lying. There was a nasty fight and there were 20 people at the meeting. So number, we can't say it were, we have to say there were 20 people. Also, we should remember some imperatives. It and there are used when there are subjects to be involved. But when we are using imperative statements, then we may not use any subject. So, shut the door. Generally, it would be you shut the door. But it is understood that there is a pronoun there and therefore we do not actually use it. Now, when we use he or him, it will refer to men. When we use she or her, it refers to women. But when we are not sure whom we are talking to, whether it is a man or a woman, we use they or them. Next, mine. The pleasure is mine. Ours. The house is ours. Yours. Is that book yours? His, this is his pen, hers, this event is hers, theirs, this car is theirs. Now these are the things that are used which are called as possessive pronouns. Pronouns that will show some kind of possession or you own it. So when I say the pleasure is mine, I own that pleasure. Now if you take a look over here, everywhere apart from mine, S is there. Ours, yours, hers, theirs. But there is no apostrophe. So when we are using possessive pronoun, we do not use apostrophe. Okay. Remember, possessive pronouns do not have apostrophe. They blamed themselves. Look at the statements carefully and the highlighted ones. She herself called me. Now, pronouns when used as the receiver of an action are called as reflexive pronoun. So, themselves is a pronoun and it is a reflexive pronoun because it is the receiver of the action blame. Likewise over here, pronouns when used to convey emphasis are called as emphatic pronoun. So, she herself. Now, look at the two statements. You will find that the pronouns over here in reflexive pronouns, we always use the pronoun after the verb. Whereas in emphatic pronoun, it is used after the main pronoun or the personal pronoun itself. So reflexive or emphatic pronouns, they look similar, but their positions are different. I hurt myself. This would be reflexive pronoun. You yourself chose these shoes. This would be emphatic. Because reflexive pronoun comes after the verb, emphatic pronoun comes before the verb. They had to cook for themselves. Now here again, reflexive pronoun, because it is coming after the verb cook, and it could also be after a preposition. He was feeling very sorry for himself. Again a reflexive pronoun. Kendal itself is quite a small town. Now this is an emphatic pronoun because it is coming immediately after the noun or the pronoun that is there. Now let us look at this. Who does this book belong to? What are you looking for? Which university did you go? Whose book is this? Whom did you send? All the words which are yellow highlighted, they are the question form of a word and it starts with W. Why did this happen? Now, these kinds of words which are in question form are called as interrogative pronoun. What is it? Pronouns that are used to ask questions. So, all the W type questions would be interrogative pronouns. Okay. Next, I pressed the call bell several times but nobody answered. Notice the word nobody. These facts are known to all. Some of the books were old. Now, nobody, all, some. These are the terms used for people or non-living things. And these are the pronouns that stand for some noun which are implied or which are understood. They do not stand for a specific person or thing. It is something that we understand that, okay, these books must be there or these people must be there, but not specifically some people or some book. Such are the indefinite pronouns. So we are not sure about who it is. And these are some list we can see, everybody, nobody, anybody, somebody, no one, nothing. So it could be either too many or only one, but not specific. Okay, next we look at demonstrative pronoun. These are the pronouns which are used to point out the object or objects that they are referring to. This and these. This is a nice cup of tea. Whose shoes are this? These. We use this for singular and these for plural. That and those. Again, what's that? Those are very expensive shoes. Over here, that is used for again singular and those for plural as pronouns to talk about things which are not near to us. Whereas this and these would be things that are near to us. One and ones. Which one do you want? Which ones are yours? So, one is for singular and once is for plural. Each took it in turn. Either of you can go. Neither of the accusations is true. These are distributive pronouns. And why it is distributive? Because it refers to person or thing one at a time. Each, either, neither. These are referring to one at a time. Now look at this question, this statement. A triangle whose three sides are equal is called an equilateral triangle. Okay. The person who is honest is trusted. This is the house which Jack built. These are relative pronoun. Why is it relative pronoun? What is the relative pronoun over here? Pronouns that relate a noun to a group of words that follow. So a triangle whose three sides are equal. It is relating to the noun or a group of words that are following. Okay. Equilateral triangle and triangle. The person who is honest. So the person and the honest. It relates to the value of honesty with the person, and therefore who becomes a relative pronoun. Over here, this is the house which Jack built, which becomes a relative pronoun because it relates Jack to the house. Okay. Peter and Mary helped each other. Peter helped Mary and Mary helped Peter. This is how it is understood. These both statements mean the same thing. Over here, we sent one another Christmas card, which is equivalent to we sent them a Christmas card and they sent us a Christmas card. So these are reciprocal pronouns. And what are these? Reciprocal pronouns are like each other and one another, such kind of words when used for two or more people doing the same thing, we can call it as reciprocal pronoun. So this is what we learned today. Personal pronoun, possessive pronoun, reflexive or emphatic pronoun, interrogative pronoun, indefinite pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, distributive pronoun, relative pronoun, and reciprocal pronoun. Next, in the next video. Thank you.